Commissioner Friends, thank you very much for joining us today. Calgary Economic Development is pretty excited to present you what we're calling as session four of our webinar series. If you haven't seen some of the previous webinar series, we've done in agriculture, energy, and creative industries, and we're excited for you guys to see those, and we'll share those links after this presentation. But we have a great group of participants today joining us from our local environment with Helsum and Harvest, to some new members that are joining our Team Calgary ecosystem, Altia ABM. We're all excited to kind of share what is happening in the fintech and cybersecurity sector here in Calgary and show you that it really is live and going. And we're not just an up and coming fintech sector, but it's happening here right now. So I'm going to turn things over to Crystal for a quick introduction to the TCS team. And then we're going to pass things off to Megan. We have a great video for you guys to share, and then we're going to bring things up to speed with our participants and a Q&A session at the end for you guys to be interactive with, and we hope you all can participate. If you have any questions leading up to the Q&A session, please feel free to drop them in the chat box, but we're excited to hear what you guys have to ask everyone, and yeah, this should be a great session for us today. So I'll turn it over to Crystal.
Great. Thank you so much, Mike. Hello. Bonjour tout le monde. Merci de nous avoir rejoints aujourd'hui pour ce webinaire. Thank you everyone for joining us this today for this webinar. And we're really excited and thanks to Calgary Economic Development for hosting and putting it together. And thanks for inviting us to speak. I'm Crystal Larm, Trade Commissioner, part of the ICT team here at the Regional Office for Alberta and Northwest Territories, or ROANT in our language. And I'm just really excited to have you here to learn more about what is up and coming in the Calgary ecosystem in the tech sector. Here at ROANT, we are covering all the tech sectors, and there's three of us on this file. I'm joined by Jeff Hahn and Nicole Nkunzimana. And you can always feel free to reach out to us as well if you have more questions after this webinar. And so I hope you will find the comments and the stories from the speakers to be helpful as you work on your files, both in trade and investment. I will say that Calgary Economic Development is a very good and close partner for ROANT, and we work with them a lot on both the trade side, so promoting and helping companies do business outside of Canada, and then as well as on investment in terms of helping attract inward foreign direct investment into Calgary. And so I think we'll learn more as this morning's webinar goes on. And I encourage you also to look at the past webinars that Calgary Economic Development has hosted and put on. I think those will also give you some other perspectives into other up and coming tech sectors here in Calgary. So with that, I'll turn it back over to Mike and Megan. Thank you.
Great. Thank you, Crystal. And you reminded me, I didn't even introduce myself. So my name is Mike Addersall. I'm the business development manager of our enterprise sector. I focus a lot on the technology areas and subsectors. Some of you I've spoken with in the past and some of you are new, so I can't wait to break into those new conversations. But with that said, I will pass it on to Megan and I'll just get my screen shared here and hopefully everyone can see this.
Awesome. Thanks, Mike. And thank you, Crystal. And good morning, good afternoon, good evening to our friends all around the world. I always find it interesting to share who's joined us. So looking at the list this morning, there's our TCS friends in Mexico, Belgium, Ukraine, Germany, India, US, UK, and Japan. So I'm sure you all haven't met each other, just like we haven't met you all in person, but great to have you all join us from the various time zones. So I'm happy to just share with you a few of our team members here. You can see on the next slide, Mike. The business development team obviously is ready to serve, and we pride ourselves on being quick and responsive to your needs and your client needs. And we cover all the major sectors of Calgary. So we have a fair bit of sector expertise. You've probably talked to some or all of our team here. And if we don't have the answer, we'll find it for you. So just an open call to call me and any of the team. Hopefully you're inspired by what you hear today about what's happening in cyber and fintech in Calgary, and we can follow up to support you and your clients. So given the international nature of our audience today, it's good to remind everybody how easy it is to connect with us here in Calgary. 140 destinations that the Calgary Airport flies to and 85 direct routes. Obviously, we're picking that up after COVID. Like every airline and airport in the world, that has slowed down. But we're certainly a very connected city. That's a huge advantage to doing business in Calgary. And I always like to show the map because I think it reminds people just how connected we are. So this next slide is my favorite. If you take away anything from what I'm sharing with you, this is it. As far as we know, we're the only city in Canada to quantify the market opportunity of digital transformation. And we all know this is the buzzword of the year, digital transformation. And this really aligns well with the vision of Calgary's economic strategy, which is Calgary is the city of choice for the world's best entrepreneurs. We embrace innovation and create solutions to meet the world's needs in food, health, energy, and transportation. So this is a great calling for technology companies looking to solve those global challenges. And that you know, there's an opportunity here in Calgary. $20 billion is the forecast spend on digital transformation over the next couple of years, with about 7.5 of that in Calgary. So this is quite unique. And I would hope this is maybe one of the key takeaways that you take away from today's conversation. So you may be wondering, who's making those decisions? Who's spending all that money here in Alberta? Well, you may be surprised to know that we have the highest concentration of head offices in Canada per capita, which I think surprises people. And these aren't just energy companies. So the next slide really highlights that we do have a really diverse customer base. So these are head offices and key decision makers in the energy sector, of course, and that includes renewable energy and clean technology, agribusiness, technology, manufacturing, aerospace, logistics, and life sciences. And there's just a smattering of some of the companies headquartered here in Calgary and to highlight that diversity. In fact, two of Calgary's tech unicorns, so billion-dollar companies, are in the fintech space, Benevity and ShareWorks by Morgan Stanley. And many fast-scaling tech companies that I think are quick on their heels, like Neo Financial and Helsum, who you'll get to meet shortly. I always love to highlight our enviable quality of life in Calgary. This is a really big pillar of our value proposition here. We've been voted by the Economic Intelligence Unit as the most livable city in the world for 10 straight years. And so we have to showcase that. It's tremendous. Whether that's our Rocky Mountain Playground that you probably know us for, and you can see in the photo here, the tremendous parks and urban pathway system across Calgary. And of course, we're the sunniest city in Canada. It really makes it easy to attract and retain talent here in Calgary. Of course, affordability is a major aspect of this livability, and your dollar certainly goes a long way in Calgary. This makes it possible for young talent to own their own home in our city, and you can see the contrast of, you know, Calgary's, the price to buy a home in Calgary compared to some other major global centers. So this is something we're very proud of, and certainly something that businesses and companies around the world are always telling us that, you know, we can't afford the city we're in, and Calgary is a really good option for us because you have the high quality of life, the diverse business culture, and then of course, affordability. I love to talk about the people. I think that's really important. That's what makes this community so great, and the citizens that call Calgary home. And I think it surprises people to learn how diverse our city is. 34% of our population is a visible minority. 120 languages are spoken across Calgary. And additionally, after the Calgary Stampede, Calgary Pride is our second biggest festival, and over 100,000 people participated in the last Pride Festival here in 2019. And the last slide for me, and something that's obviously very important to mention, is how business friendly Alberta is. We have the lowest corporate income tax rate in the country at 8%, and we're the only province with no provincial sales tax, no payroll tax, and no healthcare premiums. So I hope that kind of tells you a short and compelling story about why Calgary. And now I'm going to pass it over to Mike to kick things off and dive into fintech. Over to you, Mike.
Yeah, thanks, Megan. Well, before we get into the fintech decks, we're going to quickly show you guys a video. And if I can get this queued up properly, did it well in practice. So hopefully it happens well now. Really like to share you what's happening in our local ecosystem. And of course, it's not popping up all of a sudden, so you bear with me 1 second here and I will have the video queued up.
It's a really good video. It's worth the wait. This is like, we need the drum roll.
I apologize. It was working fine before. We did have it going. And now it won't show up in my items to share. So I'm not sure what's happening. Give it one more minute if I can't find this. And I don't know if you're hearing the audio, but that seems to be working on my screen.
Yeah, heard a bit of audio. Mike just didn't see it pop up for video yet.
Let's try one more time here.
Unless, Lindsay, you can share it from your screen.
Yeah, I don't see why I can't pull it up now. It's not allowing me to. Meg or Lindsay, are you able to pull it up?
Yeah, I'm just trying now.
Thank you. And while we're waiting, if you guys have questions, you want to drop in the Q&A in the comment box, feel free to.
It's 1999 in Calgary, Alberta. A couple guys scribble a business idea down on a cocktail napkin, something about administering stock options. They start a company, Solium Capital. Their first customers are oil companies, employees all over the world, but headquartered in downtown Calgary. By 2019, Solium's acquired by Morgan Stanley for a cool $1 billion. Right idea, right time, right city. Calgary, a city with the highest concentration of headquarters in the country. Huge deals get made and money really moves. The residual effect here is limitless opportunities in finance tech. Take ATB Financial. They're a provincial financial institution, but a national player in financial innovations. DC Bank, a leader in payment technology, online or point of sale. Pelsum, empowering businesses with merchant services and business software. Or Rublix, building blockchain based on fintech software. Benevity's social responsibility software is connecting iconic brands to causes that matter. BidsTech, a block trading platform moving $30 billion a month, started right here in Calgary. These companies are succeeding across the entire spectrum. Crypto, security, trading, banking, budgeting. Calgary-based companies are on the rise thanks to talented people and Alberta's fierce appetite for fintech. So you might be a small startup, an established company, or maybe just a scribble on a cocktail napkin. No matter what, Calgary is where your great ideas become billion-dollar business. Be part of the energy.
Thank you, Lindsay. We'll get back into our presentation here. Great video, really excited about that. And like Megan said, it's one of our best ones. And we even have Rob from Helsum on the call with us today. So he's gonna be excited to share a little bit more with you when we get into that part of the presentation. So Calgary really is a global financial center. We're not an up and coming one, it's happening right now. The concentration of capital investments that are here and the growing expertise that we're seeing in blockchain, cryptocurrency and capital markets, just to name a few things, are really strengthening that financial sector out west in Canada, and we're starting to become a big draw to those financial companies and what's happening in fintech. So what does that look like in our fintech sectors? Well, there are 9 areas right now that we're seeing companies really grow: the cryptocurrency, personal finance, blockchain, wealth management, paycheck, insurtech, software, crowdfunding, the regulatory side. But there are 40 plus fintech companies that are here in the city right now. 12 accelerators and incubators are really helping grow this community. But there are a lot of things that kind of stand out to us right now. It's the first that we're seeing Calgary be in. So that's the first to deploy biometric banking, first to have real-time payments, first globally to take oil and gas royalty blockchain transactions, and the first in Canada to really integrate a robot on the customer service side of financial services. And the last thing we'll touch on is Calgary's digital dollar. And Calgary was the first city in Canada to create its own digital currency, which is something I didn't know until we really got into the fintech sector, but really interesting to find out about. So what are the cybersecurity subsectors look like? Well, cybersecurity pairs really well with the fintech sector. There's a lot of importance in keeping your data secure. So we're seeing IT services, threat management, cyber risk consulting, and the technology security areas in cyber really pair well with what's happening in fintech. And these companies are kind of starting to work together, and we're seeing integration here locally in Calgary. And it's great that we're a city where integration happens really well. So to feed that funnel of this growing fintech ecosystem, we really need to look at what our talent pool looks like. And we're really starting to expand and grow in the talent area of talent. So the technology job growth in Calgary, the ratio is 6-1 with the rest of the economy. We're seeing a 300% increase in the tech training programs and a 27.5% growth in just software development programs here in Calgary. Bow Valley College was also the first Canadian hub for IBM Skills Academy. And really just trying to build that pool. So it's happening. We're not just working with what's currently here, but we also anticipate what's coming in the future. Total tech occupancy jobs, there's 42,000 of them. A lot of jobs that kind of pair well with that sector. So these are traditional non-tech related occupations of the sales, administrative, and marketing side. So we're not just catering to the tech heavy part of fintech, but also those softer skill sets that go well with it in any organization. So cybersecurity, Calgary's always shown a lot of strength in cybersecurity. The University of Calgary, Southern Alberta Institute of Technology, Bow Valley College and Mount Royal University, all post-secondary institutions that are providing programs in cybersecurity, helping grow that strength in the arena and just really work on that up and coming talent pool of junior talent. And even those displaced workers that are looking for upskilling programs, those are available to them as well. Calgary Economic Development also sees the importance of working with organizations that are private. If you've heard of the Opportunity Calgary Investment Fund, we put in $3.25 million to Alta ML and their Center of Excellence. And they're hoping over the 3-year period that they're going to be able to graduate 240 graduates and put all 240 graduates in market. They have some great partnerships with local organizations here in the energy sector and financial sector. But what's really nice about Alta ML is the program they're running is vertically scalable. So they can grow this. The more partners they have, the bigger the program, the more graduates we can push out annually. So they're a great company to work with on the AI machine learning front. And speaking of AI and artificial intelligence, the University of Alberta and AMI is really seeing that growth here in Calgary, and they're expanding their reach to the Calgary market. They're working with Google, DeepMind, Microsoft, and again, that oil and gas and financial sectors with ATB and RBC. So we're seeing AI really be part of that fintech sector and how machine learning is really integrating well on all aspects of fintech. Another important program that OSIP got behind was the SAFE Digital Transformation Hub. And we put $8.2 million of investment into this. What's great about the SAFE Digital Transformation Hub is it's going to be right in the heart of our downtown corridor. It's 34,000 square feet. We're hoping to push out 300 graduates annually. So over 5 years, that's 1,500 graduates. So again, working on that talent pipeline and helping push and support the growing tech ecosystem and fintech ecosystem that's coming to Calgary. And we know for organizations that are a little bit on that smaller side from startup scale up, or even those are in a well-established position, Alberta's providing some funding opportunities. And if you're not familiar with these, they'd be the Alberta Jobs Now program, Canada Alberta Job Grant, Metaxas, and ICTC. All these are non-diluted funds that are going to help an organization grow and bring in that talent from our post-secondary institutions and help them with their growth here locally. So what does that ecosystem kind of look like? Well, we're doing some projections over 10 years, and this is really based on what we're seeing now and how that growth has come to be today from the tech startup community, junior tech, senior tech, major tech, and just the super major, and as Megan referred to them, those unicorn companies that we're seeing here in Calgary. But we're seeing a projected job growth from 18,000 jobs to 45,000 jobs in a 10-year period. So that's really something reflective of the attraction that Calgary has to bring companies here and really grow and provide an ecosystem where there are other organizations that they can work closely with. We do have a great talent pool, and they are going to be able to grow here locally in Calgary. And with growth, there's also the attraction of bringing in some funds. So some notable investments into Calgary companies in the fintech sector. If we look at Cement and Benevity and what they've brought in recently, that $127 million and $40 million. And I shouldn't just focus on fintech completely. It's nice to highlight some other areas where we're seeing some attraction and investment as our organizations grow here locally in Calgary. So you'll see Adabotics and Blackline Safety are some great stories outside of fintech that are receiving funding as well. So the unicorns, of course, you know, when we get to that $1 billion mark, it's nice to really share that story. Benevity ShareWorks in the fintech sector, really great to see what they've been able to do. And we're really hoping organizations that follow in their footsteps here in Calgary have that ability to do that here with the support from our organizations and the post-secondaries that we have locally here in Calgary. So with that, I will end my presentation. And just let me know and if that's okay, Megan, a thumbs up, if I'm back on the screen. Yeah, okay, perfect. Well, we brought in three participants in our panel today, Rob Waters, Rob Park, and Ariana D'Amato, and we're all from Rob Waters is from Alti ABM. We have Rob Park from Helsum and Ariana D'Amato from Harvest. But I think we'll start locally here. And I want to kick things off with Helsum, Rob Park, who's a chief operations officer. If you're able to turn your mic on, we're seeing who doesn't keep their mic on mute as they begin to speak. And we'll get started with you with a quick introduction of your organization as we move things along, and we'll pass it to Rob Waters to Ariana D'Amato after you're complete.
Cool. Great. Hi, everybody. Welcome. This is working. I think I just heard myself, actually, so that must be working. I'm Rob. I'm the CEO of Helsum. I left a career in real estate, everything I knew, to join Helsum about 6 years ago, become their COO. A bit crazy, but here we are. At that time, there were 16 of us. We're now almost 90 people, actually just over 90 people, marching towards 100. What does Helsum do? I'll try to be as quick as possible, a little bit of history and then where we're going. But Helsum started in 2007. We're a kind of unique Calgary-built company. We don't have private equity or VC at this point. It's bootstrapped. It's taken a while to build something like this. Fintech is complicated. It's regulation and software and all that sort of stuff. But started off as a reseller with a partner bank out of the US. And of course, weren't satisfied just being a reseller, so started building technology on top of their rails. And as we got bigger and more opinionated, or have a greater vision for our service, we did what kind of can happen where, you know, the forward-looking upstart starts to butt heads against the entrenched, like incumbent organizations. So we went to the bank and said, we need a new way to offer our services. We have all these things we want to do. We want to be creative with the service. The service is payments. We're a payments company. So especially for small and medium-sized businesses, we specialize in trying to develop a platform for them to accept payments, but also like do things that the big guys kind of do. But you know, they don't have the budgets for developers and things like that. So kind of interfaces they can click through and kind of expand their reach to their customers and, you know, get their funds and grow their businesses. So when we started to butt heads against the bank that we were partnered with, we found a new pathway through payment facilitation. So payment facilitation is probably some people know what it is, but it's like, if you think about it from in a real world context, that's like Square, Stripe, PayPal. They all have the same kind of payment facilitation agreement we have to offer our services. So we really moved into doing things ourselves. We are now executing on that vision step by step, hiring, growing, and built all here in Calgary. So our entire tech stack is built ourselves, with local talent, local people, local support. Everything's here. It's fantastic. Is that good enough? Should I say more?
That's perfect, Rob. Thank you very much. Well, I'll turn things over to our friends at Harvest and Ariana D'Amato, who is the head of international relations. What's nice about Ariana, she also works with Neo Financial, who is one of our fintech organizations right here in Calgary. So Ariana, when you're ready, the floor is yours.
Sure. Hi, everyone. I'm Ariana. So I work for Harvest Builders, which is a venture studio here in Calgary. So as a venture studio, we have a portfolio of companies that we're internally building, meaning that we've built out the thesis for the companies, the business plans, and recruit founders into them, and then use our back-end services here of back-end office services, marketing support, communications, finance, and all the rest to help build these companies up through their seed stage. And then once they get into a Series A, they kind of slowly start building their own teams, and we kind of step off, if you will. I myself, a little bit of interesting story because the founders of Harvest Builders and Neo Financial, which is one of our first portfolio companies, were the founders of Skip the Dishes, another great kind of unicorn here in Canada that was actually built in Winnipeg. And for those in Europe, it was later acquired by the Just Eat and now Just Eat Takeaway Group, if you're familiar with that. So I think it's a really great story of, you know, founders really wanting to build in the kind of prairie provinces, not going to the norm of Vancouver or Toronto, and really being able to kind of build successful companies in those regions. The founders moved to Calgary, and Chris Samer started the Harvest Builders Venture Studio, and then Andrew Chow and Jeff Adamson, the other two co-founders, started Neo Financial, which is the first company, which is a digital consumer bank, as part of our portfolio. And, you know, if we're talking about our fintech portfolio specifically, our kind of thesis is unbundling the bundle. I think Rob kind of alluded to some of the archaic roadblocks of dealing with the traditional banks. And especially here in Canada, we are one of the lowest adoptions for digital banking across the world. I think we're in the bottom 10%. So there's a massive market opportunity here. And our thesis is really to kind of unbundle and have a company build a digital bank, bring in another company and founders to build out the investment, the insurance, the real estate, the mortgage, all those different type of companies, so we can move faster. What may take a normal bank to kind of build in 20 years, we're hoping to do in a very condensed time frame. Neo Financial was started about 2.5 years ago. They're just over about 400 employees now, primarily based in Calgary with another small team in Winnipeg as well. And like Rob, building the tech stack from the ground up. So a lot has been done in a short period of time, and we're growing fast. And I think if you talk to the founders today, if they could hire 200 devs tomorrow, they would. So we're ready to charge, and we're really happy to be doing that in Calgary here.
Great. Thanks, Ariana. I really appreciate that. So I'm going to turn it over to Rob Waters, who is the Chief Commercial Officer at Altia ABM. Altia ABM is a relatively new organization to Calgary. They joined us just this year. Paul, I've been working with from their team for quite some time, but I'll turn it over to you, Rob, if the floor is yours. We've been put under the gun. I know you're relatively new to the organization as well. So here you go. Here's your chance to shine.
Yeah, thank you very much. Yeah, cheers for that. Yeah, I guess as you say, we're slightly different to Rob and Ariana's position. We're obviously a organisation that's fairly new to Calgary, and we were sort of formed in 2002 as a business. We specialise in cloud-first intelligence and investigation software. So we work a lot with sort of like the government agencies, law enforcement agencies, and sort of all of the private organisations who have that type of requirement. We obviously originally were based in Toronto. That's where we went to originally. And we've obviously now moved to Calgary. Paul's going to talk a bit more about why we moved in a moment. But from a company perspective, we're about 70 employees, roughly. We went through quite a major change in the business last year. So we did an MBO, management buyout, in conjunction with a private equity company called North Edge, who are based in the UK. And they helped us obviously achieve that. So our growth plans are suddenly become very aggressive, which what happens when you will start working with the private equity world, as always. But our business model really is to help clients and work in partnership with them to try and fight basically serious crime, fraud, forensic analytics, that sort of area as a business. So also, you know, from our point of view, we've moved to Calgary. We've got big growth plans for the whole of Canada. And obviously working with Paul and yourself, Mike, to obviously grow the business and, build our business in Calgary, really. And we've seen lots of benefits and lots of advantages in working in the city, and obviously trying to acquire clients all over the Americas region, and obviously across our other continents, Asia Pac, and obviously Europe itself. So we've got some pretty interesting clients in Canada and things already, and obviously around the world. And our intention is trying to grow to 100 employees by the middle of next year. And obviously to do that, we're having all those from Europe. We've got a lot of that kind of come from Canada. So we're looking to yourself, Mike, for some help in obviously helping us grow the business from that perspective. From a business point of view, our private equity owners obviously want to get global growth, and they've seen Calgary is a very good place for us to make our grounding in Canada, and that's what our plan is, really. And a lot of our solutions, unfortunately, are covert, so you can't talk about them much because of what they do, but they help obviously a lot of police forces do their jobs in all sorts of sectors and in scenarios as well. That's it from me. So Paul, do you want to just talk a little bit about why we chose Calgary quickly?
Yeah, absolutely. Thanks very much. I got on with Altia a little over a year ago. My background is as a former federal crown prosecutor, and I still practice law, though I find a lot of times the work I do with Altia a little more interesting and a little more engaging in some respects. Chose Calgary, and I'm really just riding on what Mike has already said. First of all, I'm based in Calgary, so that is kind of a no-brainer, rather than have to deal with Toronto. And it's not like I actually went to Toronto, but just a few basic things. Long-term plans is to grow, and if we do, office space is going to be less money in Calgary. We've got a burgeoning fintech sector in Calgary. Cost of living is much lower in Calgary. And, coming from working for the federal government where, really every penny counts, even simple things like buying paper for the printer or an ink cartridge, laserjet cartridge, we don't have a provincial sales tax. And those little things can add up. Also, when you consider the fact that we do require legal advice, I give legal advice at least initially as in-house counsel, if you will. But if we need legal advice, we have all of the major firms in Calgary, just like they do in Toronto. Though the fees are typically hourly rates, slightly lower in Calgary. I mean that affects the bottom line. And the advice is as good quality because the national firms will talk with the other cities and other regions. And so, you're paying a little bit less for hourly legal fees and other incidentals to run our business. Well, then also you factor in the lack of a provincial sales tax. Well, this is further savings for us. And again, Mike already covered this, but low commercial property taxes. Calgary is a hub. I'm a bit biased. I was raised in Calgary, lived in Edmonton. I went to school in Quebec City. I went to school in Cardiff, Wales. All great places. My wife's family's from Southern Ontario, but Calgary really is a great place. I mean, the cost of living is low. The ability to own property. I invested in many respects a lot of personal capital, no pun intended, with my fellow directors on Altia to make the move. And I don't even think I needed to do that. They just saw the benefit of, being in Calgary. And I think so far so good. And then we have support from individuals like Mike and Megan and Lindsay, and the Alberta government is, really pushing and emphasizing the fintech sector. I mean, I just think this is the place to be. So that's our story.
That's great, Paul, and thanks. You kind of gave me the great interlude into getting to our Q&A session. That was going to be one of my first questions for you is, at what juncture did and why did you consider Calgary? But you've answered that really well. So this is going to be a great opportunity now for our attendees. If you have any questions, you feel free to drop into the chat box. Maybe I'll get started with the first question here. And I'm going to direct this at Rob Park from Helsum. But while I'm doing that, please feel free to drop your Q&A into the comment box. If you can't see the comment box, just at the bottom of your Zoom screen, scroll down, you can click on the chat icon and it will pop up on the right-hand side of your screen there. But for you, Rob, I was kind of curious, what are the cities in Canada do you feel really compete with Calgary? And, what do you view as Calgary's biggest strength for growing your business?
What other cities that compete with Calgary? I mean, it's a tricky one. I'm born and raised here, so I'm like, none. But it's like they all have different options or different attributes to offer. But I think for Calgary, what I've really noticed here is there's a few things. One of the biggest things is we just get stuff done. There's just a real kind of I don't know if it comes from kind of the frontier town days or what have you, but it's just kind of, you have a problem, you solve it. You have a problem, you solve it. You keep moving. You're not afraid to kind of push boundaries to get to a different place. But we've managed to assemble a team of people who are here, a lot of juniors, a lot of people fresh out of the universities. Universities are great, We really believe in junior hiring and kind of building them up and moving them through the company. And we just tackle projects that are bigger than people would expect of us. And we get to the other side and we learn from them and we carry on. And so from my standpoint, like what makes Calgary kind of unique and exciting is that kind of can-do adventurous spirit that just allows us to get more done than I think other places, other cities that you could go to. I think that's one of the key things for me.
Yeah, that's great, Rob. I think, Paul, you wanted to add something to that.
Yeah, I do, actually. And, you know, I want to mention that can-do attitude, entrepreneurial, absolutely. You know, and this goes back to my undergrad of Canadian history. You know, at the turn of the century, and I know this is still, well, the other century, a long time ago, but, you know, nonetheless, the ethos does carry over. And just prior to Alberta becoming a province in 1905, one out of every third of you know, newcomers to Alberta was from the United States. And the United States is very entrepreneurial. And that work ethic, that can-do attitude and entrepreneurial spirit really has carried through. And well, this next comment is, you know, somewhat anecdotal. I think it's still quite true as a general rule, though things are changing. My wife from Southern Ontario got her call and, you know, got her call to the bar in Toronto, started practicing there. But she has said to this day, since we moved to Calgary, we had a short stint in Ottawa for me, but that's another story. She said, you know, there's just no way she would have had the same success if she'd stayed in Toronto than she has here in Calgary. You know, there still is very much a established class, if you will. That might be a bit extreme, but, you know, there's still an old guard in Toronto, whereas, you know, Calgary is very much you make it or you break it. It's still very entrepreneurial. So yeah, that has a lot to be said for Calgary.
Yeah, and that's a really good point, Paul. It kind of brings me around to Ariana, because she's dealing with these entrepreneurs in the startup community. So one of the things we get asked a lot too are, what are some of the financial advantages? Are there additional incentives that you see the startup community and scale-up community looking for, those Alberta grants that are available here? And really, are there anything that companies really need to help get that startup going?
Yeah, to be honest, I haven't. There are some federal grant programs that are available in Alberta. We utilize them in Winnipeg as well, when at Skip the Dishes. One of the biggest things, though, going back to kind of the talent side, because to Rob's point, there's a lot of junior talent, especially within kind of the engineer developer space here. So we have great university programs. We're getting a lot of that great junior talent. But across Canada, getting good senior, you know, product developers is a challenge for everyone. And that's where all the cities across Canada and North America are really competing. And I think where we've really found success is being able to bring in international talent, and being able to bring in a place and recruit it into Calgary is a fantastic opportunity, because you do have such an amazing cost of living. The place in itself, I think you guys spoke wonders to the city and the spirit here, the people here, the, you know, the mountains and just the proximity of where you are in Canada as well. It makes it a really easy place to recruit. And we were recruiting in Winnipeg before, where it's like minus 40 for too many months of the year. So it's definitely been a little bit easier being able to bring in that really hard to find talent that you need when you're developing, you know, your tech stack from the bottom up. And you have such an emphasis on that tech talent. So that's been a huge advantage to kind of building in Calgary.
Yeah.
I was going to lead it right to you and ask you, you know, this is a great thing to, like, how does Pelsum really work on keeping talent and growing their talent here in Calgary?
We have great relationships with the schools. Like, you know, we're out there. We've worked hard to build those relationships. You know, it's also building a great culture that has people that want to work there, right? So kind of just really involved leadership and, you know, word of mouth and just being on the streets and present. And, you know, I think, and having that presence with juniors as well and bringing them in and kind of nurturing them. And, you know, they've got friends who they went to school with, and it just kind of rolls on from there. But I think I was going to add previously to the previous conversation a bit about, like, there's a lot of conversation about cost of living and things like that. And I really think, like, you know, happy employees or productive ones, like, that's key. Like, you can't build good products or offer good service if your people aren't happy. And it's like the key thing for cost of living is it allows, and whether they're young staff or older ones, like you can hit milestones in your life. You can have those like unlocks that people want to reach, whether it's like starting a family, owning property, all that sort of stuff, going on a vacation once a year. You know, it's a balance where you can get paid a decent wage and you can also achieve things in your personal life that kind of gives this whole kind of life fulfillment sort of thing that can kind of bring things forward. Where if you're in other locations where like the cost of a house is 800 or 900,000 and not the best place, like how do you then start to unlock those milestones in your life to feel like you're achieving something for yourself while you're doing your work? And so I think from the Calgary standpoint, it gives that great balance of there's great wages here and those wages go a lot farther. And that promotes kind of this feeling of fulfillment and happiness in the staff because they can go and achieve those things and meet those milestones that if they were other places, they would struggle to do so.
Right. And I think those are all fantastic points. And when I'm working with organizations, there's a lot of talk on how do we help attract talent to Calgary, not only keep them here. So we really do sell Calgary's lifestyle and that value proposition of a great quality of life, cost of living. You know, it, like Ariana alluded to it, it's kind of easier to attract people to a place where we got a lot of sunshine and it's not so cold. And we work in partnerships with companies like yourselves. We have a great, for the trade commissioners, we have a great client excellence team. They focus a lot on the talent, the real estate side. So, you know, if you guys ever need those numbers of what it's like to, you know, the numbers of the cost of living as Megan presented, whether it's going to be commercial or real estate, and then just across the board, what life in Calgary is like. And on our website, there's a great link to life in Calgary, and it gives you a lot of statistics and what's great about being here. So coming here with Altia ABM, I guess my question to you is like, when you guys looked at coming to Calgary, if you could identify one factor that was a key decision in helping with your bottom line, was it going to be the taxes? Was it going to be the cost of talent? If you really had to drill down to that one item, what would it be? And, you know, Rob or Paul, feel free to answer this question.
I'll jump in and if Rob has anything to add, but for me in the short term, it was dollars and cents. Absolutely. Dollars and cents, it financially just makes sense, and part of it was getting a bill from the lawyers in Toronto where we had our law firm, and no criticism, it just, you know, you pay $1,000 and now you got to pay 13% HST, harmonized sales tax, that same amount in Calgary, you're only paying 5%. Right. I mean, it's really that simple. And then, you know, further, that presumes that it actually was $1,000 that it would cost in Calgary. And it just doesn't. The quality of the legal advice, the quality of the services we get in Calgary, I think are comparable to Toronto. They're more economical. And, you know, as much as Altia is, I would say, an established organization company, in Canada, we're not. And for me, being very fiscally prudent, raised on the prairies, Saskatchewan, Alberta, it's all about hard work and, you know, really maximizing your dollars. And then, you know, one of the pitches, and I'm going to let Rob jump in here, was just, I said, I think there's going to be the talent pool and the possibility to really grow because, you know, one of our, you know, our vision, as much as we're a global company, is to use Canada as its launching point south towards United States, Central and South America, where we already have clients, right? And Calgary is just logically a good place to be. Rob Waters, anything to add?
Yeah, no, I was gonna say, you just sort of, Karen and Paul say, obviously we are looking to build out our sales teams across, you know, Canada and the States as well, like Paul mentioned, and we're seeing Calgary as our base to do that, but also tech talent in the UK, where we typically have done it from, is pretty expensive. You know, you don't get much for your buck regards, even graduates or people with experience under their belts, it's really expensive. So it's very hard to build out your tech development team, especially when you're trying to grow the tech as quickly as we are. So we're seeing Calgary as a great place to get some of that new talent on board in the business. And also we're going to expand out the sales teams and the tech teams in Calgary, which will then navigate its way across the states as well. So that's our current vision and plan of what we're doing there. So we're seeing it as a hub for us really. And obviously that hub's gonna get bigger and bigger. And eventually we'll build the team out even more than that, you know, to make it a self-fulfilling unit within Calgary itself. And that's really the vision from the board and from the private equity company that owns us, you know, they're giving us the funding to be able to do that. So we're going to have the investment going into Calgary from our side, and it's going to be across several different roles of the business. But we're starting with the tech side, because we're seeing that as a good place and a good hub for us, really. So, yeah. Great.
Thanks. Well, we do actually have a question here in the Q&A, and one of the comments, and we can add to this as well from our organization's perspective, but could one of you please comment on Calgary's fintech company's interest to explore foreign markets, which market stand first? So maybe this is for you, Rob.
Me? This Rob? Cool. Yeah. I have some thoughts. I mean, we're already operating in the US, like we have our services there. All the staff are still in Calgary, but you know, the connections are great. You know, our acquiring bank is in Atlanta. So, you know, as far as like actually practically making something work and offering service in the US, that's all going well. And then as far as like other markets considering, I mean, you know, because of the bank that we are, that kind of does the back end servicing, it's just the way the payment industry works. You have to have like a substantial bank behind you. We have rails into Europe and South America. So, you know, we're going to get really, really good at North America first, because fintech is complicated. Payments involves AML, KYC, identity verification, all that sort of stuff. So, we're going to hone our skills, some are familiar, but then probably leap likely into Europe next, just because I think, I still have a lot of research to do on this, but I think from a legal standpoint, the law is fairly similar. And then also like the tools to kind of do those regulatory exercises are kind of more in place versus other places which may be less familiar for us. So that's right, kind of how, that's how we're looking at the world a bit.
Yeah, that's great, Rob. And you know, something that our organization has too is our TAP program, or Trade Accelerator Program. And we work closely with local organizations to help expand their growth internationally. We run cohorts annually. I think there's three more cohorts left for the year. And we really do focus on some of these roadblocks Rob was talking about, whether it's going to be on the regulatory side or the tax side, and expanding from there. And you know, from what Paul said too, we have great team Calgary partners that work with us, and these law firms can help provide some of that guidance, not only inbound, but also outbound for companies looking to grow. So that was really good, because I was going to ask you there, Rob Park, like what are some of your biggest roadblocks in your sectors? But when we talk about fintech, like regulatory really is a big issue. So if you want to touch on that lightly, like what have you done with the Calgary market to kind of help get around that regulatory side?
I mean, the regulatory side, like for us, is just like there weren't a lot of roadblocks. It was just a lot of thinking and figuring it out, like as far as like connecting the dots and doing the kind of the regulatory checks. I think for us, like the biggest hurdle was getting a bank to say yes in the first place. And that was like first experience, like Nick, our founder, 2007, 23-year-old shaved head punk. Like nobody wanted to kind of say like, hey, yeah, we'll give you the kind of some keys to the kingdom here and you can start selling financial services, until one bank eventually did, who wanted a greater presence in Canada. What I find for us is the lack of cooperation from Canadian financial institutions. So that's kind of like my big hurdle. So when there's chances to talk about open banking and like real-time rails for payments and opening up like the payments networks and that whole thing, I'm in there like a dirty shirt, and I'll go and fight that fight as soon as we can, because I think that's kind of the hurdle we face. And with the conversations around open banking and pushing it, I think Ariana was mentioning that we're like, you know, they're coming. Canada's kind of behind as far as these like integrated financial services go. So that's, you know, that's room. It's good though. It's good to have a hurdle, because it gives us something to work towards and somewhere we can disrupt and bring change. So. But that's kind of where we see the hurdle. And so we're pushing it forward through industry groups and chats with politicians and all sorts of stuff.
Yeah, and it's great. I think our local ecosystem here, pushing that digital transformation, that digital change, as Megan highlighted, that $24.48 billion spend that we're going to see in Alberta, and how it's broken that down across industries is kind of fantastic. So through this like digital transformation, maybe I'll come to you, Ariana, again. You know, this digital transformation that's happening in Calgary, does that kind of help support the company growth? Like those that are coming to Harvest that want to grow their business, do they see Calgary as that digital transformation? Is that why they're coming here? And do are there enough support groups? Let's make it a two-part question. Are there enough support groups in our local ecosystem that help with the digital transformation that companies are trying to establish here?
Yeah, I think we actually, Harvest works with a lot of, new entrepreneurs and startups, but we also work with a lot of more institutional and, corporate companies that have been around for years that are going through this digital transformation. And we support a lot on, finding them the right talent and helping them kind of develop those new teams. I think there's definitely a push towards it, and you definitely get a feeling in the community that this is the direction we're going, especially with a little bit of a diversification from the traditional kind of oil and gas industry here. In terms of the ecosystem, I think Calgary is really unique. I'm originally actually from Vancouver as well, so I've had experience in the Vancouver, the Winnipeg, and now Calgary market. Winnipeg has a very collaborative ecosystem here, specifically within the kind of the tech ecosystem. It's very young though, so you have a lot of people trying to do a lot of different things, and there's a lot of new organizations and new programs coming up to support. I think what will come in the next few years, and honestly within the past year of being here, I've seen it just develop tenfold, is just a little bit of better coordination between those groups, so we can better help guide entrepreneurs and founders or those going through this more digital transformation in those larger institutions, just help guide them through a little bit better. Right now there's a lot of people, it's like you come in and you have like a lot of hands out open going, okay, we want to help you, but it's not necessarily a clear path of how an entrepreneur can go. And I think that's where we see communities like Waterloo and stuff that are just a little bit more a little further along that path, have a little bit more structure for entrepreneurs. But Calgary in the past year has, done an amazing job of kind of coming together. And I think next year I'll be saying, very similar thing, because I can already see the work that's being done in 2021, 2022, and it's only getting stronger.
Yeah, no, that's a great point. When we talk about cities like Toronto, Vancouver, they probably have had like a 6 to 8 year runway on Calgary and where Calgary is coming, this digital transformation we're seeing. But I think just how fast Calgary is going through it, the adoption, how people are drawn to the city, I don't think it's going to take Calgary that 6 to 8 years. And this is my personal opinion. I think we're going to grow really fast. But I love the support that yourself and Rob are saying about the growing ecosystem here.
The attitude is quite different as well, I would say. It's a much more friendlier, collaborative attitude in Calgary. And I think that's just what's going to make it excel so much quicker, is that there's not a lot of, at least I don't feel it's competing against each other. Everyone's, how can we help each other? And how can we move this along faster? So I think they're... is a big advantage for Calgary as well.
Yeah, and I think it goes back to what Rob said too, just in Calgary, things get done. And I love how we talk about Calgary being this big, small city where you can walk down our centralized business district and really make connections in line for coffee or at a pub or on a patio, and deals get done in the city that fast. There's not the layers of organizational pillars where you have to go through just to meet the right person. So it's fantastic. But we talk a lot about talent. We're talking about the quality of life. I'd like to hear from Alti ABM. Now that you guys are here in Calgary, are there members of your UK team who want to be relocated because of what Calgary has to offer? Have those talks been going? Like Rob Waters, are you chomping at the bit to get over here and experience our plus 40 degree weather we've had this summer or the minus 30 we might get in the winter?
Yeah, I think we have minus 30 all the time actually in the UK. So... Yeah, our summers aren't that great, but it's an interesting point actually, Mike, because we're obviously recruiting at the moment, various roles in the UK and obviously in Canada. But one thing we keep saying to people is obviously that what we talk about it, as an opportunity for them to obviously relocate and actually move to Calgary to actually work for us there. So we have a few sales managers who've already put their hands up to want to move over actually, because they like the lifestyle, and they've heard obviously, as we talked about, the cost of living is great over there. In the UK, it's not. It's an expensive place to be, really, on a personal level. So, and it's only getting worse. So, yeah, so having that view of Calgary is really good. But, yeah, so we're giving that opportunity to all of our sales teams, though, and also our product development teams in that respect, to actually to come out and do that and take the opportunity if they want to do that. So that's something we're going to continue to do. And obviously, we sell the benefits, and Paul sells the benefits of obviously being have that as an opportunity for the business, really. And we're selling it as a another arm and extension to our business that our competitors can't offer because they don't have locations over there. So it, for us, it's a benefit. And, you know, some of our teams will definitely be moving. I see that as definitely a route to path for their careers as well. People want to come and experience the lifestyle and the lovely temperatures. And if you do get that, summers like that would be great. So it's, summers like that and skiing in the winter. So that's brilliant. My perspective. Is it 10 ski resorts you have around you? I think that's what I know. It's quite a few.
Yeah, well, so I think it depends how far you want to drive. But yes, there are.
As far as you like when it comes to skiing. Yeah, it's great.
Yeah, and our team definitely can help on all those levels with any organization about, what it's going to be like to live in Calgary, the quality of life, and from all aspects, you know, referring back to our client excellence team, to even the business development team, really helping your company get integrated and helping those employees start their life up here. Even it's through, we realize when an organization moves here, you're moving your partner as well. So for them to help find work in a diverse economy like Calgary as well, not just oil and gas or tech, but from life sciences to agriculture, to our creative industries, we have a plethora of organizations in all sectors where we can grow. So we're up to the last 3 minutes here of this presentation, this webinar. I think I'm going to ask one question and I'll give a chance for each of you to answer it. But right now, if you had to give advice to another organization that was considering Calgary, what is the one selling point that you think Calgary offers that really defines us as a city? And it can be from that quality of life to the cost of doing business. What would be that one piece of advice that you'd like to give an organization considering Calgary? So I'll give it to Rob Park first, and then Ariana, and we'll finish with Rob Waters here.
I just come back to, it's an adventurous city with a can-do spirit, and you can come here and your staff will have a great experience. Like, they'll live great lives and they'll get amazing things done, and all for like less than another place you could go. It seems to be the theme, but like that's really it. It's a fantastic place. There's creative people. They get stuff done. They're not afraid of adventures and tackling problems. And, they can balance that kind of can-do attitude, adventurism out with, quality of life that allows them to also, invest in other parts of their life and enjoy more than just their work. So I think that would be the advice I would give. The sooner you do that, the better. Happy people.
Thanks, Rob. And for you, Ariana?
I'll probably second that as someone that's also just moved to Calgary in the last, I guess, a year and a half. I really do think the quality of life is a huge selling point for building a business or recruiting people into Calgary. And the ecosystem that is growing here, I think that there's just so much opportunity. There's so much collaboration. And it really does make it easy for companies coming in to make those connections and to find that support.
Yeah, that's great. And Rob, I'll let you finish things off here for today and a little spin on people that want to follow in Altia ABM's footsteps.
I mean, my initial view at the moment is obviously with the impact that we've had as a business by being in Calgary, it's been a lot better than it has in other places. So we've been in the Asia Pac a lot longer, yet the impact we've had in Calgary has been a lot quicker, and we've seen a lot more benefits coming out of our location there as well, from a sales perspective and from obviously from the tech and talent side as well. And also having Paul on board to help us in those areas, we've moved forward much quicker. So from my perspective, we're only going to grow bigger and better. And, hopefully we'll have the continued success that we've had already in the region, and it will be our hub for selling out Altia's products across Canada and in the States. So that's my view, is that it definitely seems like the place to be, whether it's UK headquartered or another company in another country. So
that's great. Well,
complete package. We started here and we're not leaving. So,
well, I want to thank all our panelists. I know you guys are all busy running your businesses, and it is a valuable piece of your time that you're giving us today. So, we really appreciate you being part of this and really sharing Calgary's story and helping tell our trade commissioner friends of all the fun things and great things that our city is doing. We look forward to our next webinar series that we have, and for the trade commissioners that are involved here today, we will be following up with you with a link to this presentation. We'll provide our slide deck, of course, that sector video, which is great. And if you have any follow-up questions for us, please feel free to reach out to myself or Megan or Lindsay. If you'd like to be in contact with any of our panelists here today, please let us know. but we really appreciate everyone's time. Everyone's time is valuable these days, and you know, Zoom's still here, so we're all still taking part in it, but really appreciate everyone, and thank you for attending. Appreciate it.